all my healthcare brothers and sisters. I hope that y'all are having a wonderful day. We're going to continue on this ATI math review journey, and we're going to start discussing geometry and parameters. In this video, I'd like to go ahead and extend an invitation for you to go ahead and subscribe to me down below. If you haven't already subscribed, where have you been, all my ATI Teas people? Make sure that you hit that big thumbs up to let other people know that are looking for the ATI Teas reviews that I'm doing a good job and that this information is helpful for you for passing your ATI Teas like a boss. Let's get started. A parameter is defined as a measure of length around the exterior of a shape. So just think about the parameter around your home. It's the measurement around the exterior surrounding of your home, say, such as your fence. In order to find the parameter of a rectangle, you simply just need to add all four lengths together to get the correct answer. However, if you need to find the parameter of an irregular shape, you might need to subtract different values to find the missing values. Let's take a look at an example. Let's take a look at the parameter of this shape. We have an L-shaped parameter here. However, we have two missing values, x and y. In order to determine the parameter of this shape, we need to determine what the missing values are of x and y. How do we do that? Let's figure that out. So starting with x, the vertical side of the left side of the shape is equal to 6, and the vertical side of the right side of the shape is equal to 2. So we know that the missing value has to be equal to 6, but less than 2. So we're going to go ahead and subtract these two values. 6 minus 2 is equal to 4, so we know that the missing value of x is equal to 4. Moving on to try to figure out what the y value is of our equation, we know that the horizontal side of the bottom of the shape is equal to 5, and the horizontal piece of the top of the shape is equal to 2. This means that the missing horizontal value must be equal to 5, but less than 2. We go ahead and subtract those, 5 minus 2, and we get the missing value for y is 3. Finally, all we need to do is add all of our values together. We have 6 plus 5 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2 is equal to 22. The parameter of this shape is equal to 22. Not all shapes are squares and rectangles. Some shapes are circles. How do we figure out the parameter of a circle? Well, that's called the circumference. So how do you figure out the circumference of a circle? Well, there's two equations. The first equation is C is equal to 2 pi r, and the second equation is C is equal to pi d. R in the first equation is equal to the radius of the circle, and d in the second equation is equal to the diameter of a circle. Let's take a look at an example to figure this out. What is the circumference of a circle with a radius of 4 centimeters? Well, first we know that we're going to be using the first formula that we discussed, C is equal to 2 pi r, because we know the radius is 4. R is equal to 4. Well, since r is equal to 4, we're going to plug that into our equation. So that leaves us with C is equal to 2 pi 4. But again, we've got some like terms here. We've got two whole numbers, so we're going to multiply those together. 2 times 4 is equal to 8, so we know that the circumference of this particular equation is 8 pi centimeters. In addition to parameters, the ATI Teas will test your knowledge of finding area. Area is defined as the amount of space taken up by a two-dimensional object. And we're not looking at three-dimensional objects, we're simply looking at two-dimensional objects. What we see is what we get. This can be measured in units squared, square inches, yards, miles, etc. Unfortunately, there's not an easy way to memorize all of these equations. It's just going to be something that you're going to have to know. Just like with anything in healthcare, it's a lot of memorization of equations and different factors. But I've listed some of the common shapes and formulas for your review. Let's start off with the square. We know that a square has four equal sides. Each side is equal to the same. So all we need to do is take one of those sides and square it. So the ultimate equation to find out the area for the square is A is equal to S squared. Moving on to our rectangle. Our rectangle is almost the same. However, we've got two sides that are the same and two different sides that are the same. So in order to figure out the area of a rectangle, we're going to take the area is equal to length times width. So the parallelogram is another one of those funny shapes that you don't see a whole lot, but the ATI Teas wants you to figure out how to do the equation. So to find the area of a parallelogram, we're going to take the base, because both the bases, whether it's the top or the bottom, are equal to the same, and we're going to times that by the height. So the area of a parallelogram is base times height. Just like the parallelogram, like a trapezoid, it's almost the same equation. However, with a parallelogram, we have two equal bases versus a trapezoid, we have two unequal bases. So how do we figure this out? It's basically the same equation. However, we're going to add base 1, which is the top of the trapezoid, by base 2, the bottom of the trapezoid, and we're going to divide that by 2. So the equation for the area of a trapezoid is A is equal to half base 1 plus base 2 multiplied by height. If you haven't started to figure it out, we're kind of seeing a pattern here. Whether it's with the rectangle, the parallelogram, or the trapezoid, it's always length times width or base times height. It's really the same equation. Just like those, the triangle is really the same. However, because we only have one base, we have to divide it by 2. So the area for a triangle is A is equal to half the base times the height. And lastly, that circle's gonna come up and mess it up for everybody. That's the one equation that you're gonna have to memorize well that doesn't really correspond with anything else. So the area of a circle is A is equal to pi r squared. Like with the perimeter of a circle, we know that the circumference is almost the same as the area. However, you can use a diameter when you're figuring out the circumference of a circle, but you cannot when you're trying to figure out the area. If an equation gives you the diameter of a circle, all you're going to do is divide that number by 2. That's going to give you half of these diameter, and that is going to be the radius. So you can go ahead and plug it into your equation. So A is equal to pi r squared. Now that we understand how to find the area for two-dimensional objects, we need to start looking at the surface area of three-dimensional objects. So the surface area is defined as the sum of the exterior areas of a three-dimensional object. So for example, a common shape such as a square in three-dimensional form is a six-sided cube. The surface area would be 6 times the area of one side. We know that the area of a two-dimensional object, for specifically a square, is A is equal to S squared. But we've got 6 sides. So ultimately, the surface area is going to be A is equal to 6 times S squared. If you haven't done so already, I want you to head over to my website at www.nursecheung.com. There I've got additional resources for you for your ATITs exam. That includes additional practice questions for you to take on your own if you're having some difficulty with these topics. I've also included the PowerPoints if you want to print those out and take notes as we're going along, and as well as the PDF, the Word document, where, you know, everybody learns a little bit differently. Some people learn better with PowerPoint notes and some people learn better with just the Word document itself. So go ahead and go over there and check that out so that way we can pass this ATITs the first time and kill it like a boss. So I hope that this information was helpful for you to pass your ATITs math portion of the exam. I'm going to start doing some Facebook Live videos of review questions and different topics on the ATITs that may help you get a better understanding and get some additional practice in before you step in there and hopefully reduce that anxiety so that you don't have to worry about this. You know you're going to pass this like a boss. So go ahead and go on over there. Make sure that you like that page. That's facebook.com/nursecheung, where I'll be posting when I'll be doing those videos. That's hopefully at a convenient time for you. If not, they'll go ahead and be posted down here so that you can kind of play along with me as we did over on Facebook, just kind of on your own practice. But if you're not already following any of my social media, go ahead and check me out. I'm at Nurse Cheung on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. But until next time, I hope that y'all are having a wonderful day, and I look forward to speaking with you all again soon. Bye!